Hello everyone. I thought of making this quick video to introduce you guys to a new Blender add-on I recently created. With this, you can import SVG paths into Blender as shape keys. To install the add-on, just download the file given in the link in the description. Go to Blender, click File, User Preferences, and then click Install Add-on from File. Go to the folder where you have downloaded the .py file. In my case, it's on desktop. So I select the file shapekeyimport.py and install add-on from file. Now click in the edit box and type import. You should be able to see this import paths and shape keys from SVG command. Select this checkbox and save user settings. Then you can close the dialog. Now we need to create the shapes in an SVG editor. I'm using Inkscape. Let's create some simple paths quickly. We can even add text and maybe an arbitrary path. Okay, the geometric shapes that you add in Inkscape are not actually paths until you invoke this option, path object to path. This is a mandatory step. Before you do any kind of transformation, convert all the shapes to paths. This need not be converted because it's already a path. Now we need to establish a relationship between them. We need to indicate the add-on, which of them is the target and which of them are shape keys. The quickest way to do that is grouping them. So select all of them and press Ctrl G. Invoke the Xml editor. Here you can see the actual paths that we have created. Okay, the text is collection of paths. So individual letter is actually a path, but we need a single path to be able to have a shape key out of it. So we need to first of all ungroup it. I'll press Ctrl U, ungroup, and then combine the paths. I do that by clicking path and then combine, Ctrl K. So this is now a single path. In the group, you can see we have 1, 2, 3, 4 paths, and the path at the top is actually treated as the target. If you want to have any other path as the target, you simply move it up. For example, if I want to have circle as the target, I raise the node, it will be at the top. Nothing will change here. Let's save this file as sample.svg, go to Blender, switch to top mode by pressing 7 on numpad, and then press space bar. Now if I say import here, you will see the import paths and shape keys option. There are a number of options on the left hand side for importing the shape keys. First option lets the add-on know that we want to import by group, just the way we did now. The second option is a little more flexible. We'll have a look at it a little later. Third option lets the add-on know that basically we want also to import the shape keys as individual paths. Otherwise, they won't be imported as paths, but only as shape keys. The fourth option is for importing non-target paths. If I create different paths, which are neither a target nor a shape key, and I want to import these paths as well, then I can check this option. This is checked by default. If I uncheck these two and check this, this add-on works as plain SVG import add-on with a few enhancements. This option is for importing paths from hidden layer. Inkscape, for example, allows you to create layers which you can mark as hidden. If you want to import the paths from these layers as well, you can check this box. Origin to geometry sets the origin of individual paths to their geometric center. You can set the X and Y scale here and Z location. And this option allows you to copy properties like extrude, value, or depth, or any material that you have on existing curves onto the imported paths. If we create the curve, it will appear here. And if we select it here, all the properties of that curve will be applied to the imported paths. The last option we will see a little later. Just click on import paths and shape keys, and we can see that the circle is imported as an individual path and other three shapes are imported as shape keys. So now if you want to, you can check here So that circle has three different shape keys. One, the second one was the text, and three, the star. And if you uncheck the relative option, all the shape keys will be applied in turn. Now let's see the other options. The import by group option allows you to have just one shape in the group as the target, and others will necessarily function as the shape keys. But if you want to have a many-to-many relationship, import by group option is not suitable. For that, we need to have this other option that we just saw, import by attribute. Let me ungroup this so that we have these four paths. Now let's say I want to have hexagon as shape key of circle, and hexagon and circle shape key of the star. In circle, I need to add one more attribute called shape keys and set the ID of the path that I want to have as shape key as the value of that attribute. So I go back to this shape key attribute I just created and I paste the ID of this path here and press set. Now this will function as the shape key of this circle. And if we want these two as shape keys of this, what I need to do is do the same thing. Add shape keys attribute to the star and then copy these two IDs. The first one is this. I need to separate them with comma if I have multiple shape keys. And this is the other one. And I click set and save this file. I go to Blender, do an import, but before that, just let's delete this so there won't be any confusion. And import paths and shape keys. We have now this relationship. This is the shape key of circle, and these two are shape keys of this, and this is neither a shape key nor a target. So this is a plain path, and we have checked this option, import non-target paths. So this will be imported as plain path. Okay, so here you can see this is actually a simple path without any shape keys. This one has one shape key that we defined, that is the hexagon. And this star will have two shape keys that we created. One is the hexagon and the second one is the circle. Okay. Now let's see the last option. We'll just delete these paths. This option is node alignment order. For that I have created one sample file. Here you can see different alignment orders. I have two top nodes on this octagon. And if I select the node alignment order as top left, out of them, the one situated on the left will be selected. And the same thing applies to the other nodes as well. If I say left top, since there are two left nodes, the topmost of the two nodes will be selected and so on. I have these two shapes included in the group already. And this octagon is the target. So I'll just move this line node up so that this becomes the target and this becomes the shape key. And we can now import these two paths. I'll keep the node alignment order default. Select this file and import shape keys. And now you can see that this is the target that is imported. And the alignment order is left bottom. Okay. And if we now change the alignment order, so let's say alignment order is right top, and I select the same file. And now if I apply the shape key, it will be right top. And that's it. I hope you have fun with this new add-on. If you have any comments or feedback, just leave them in the comment section in this video. Thank you.